Hi guys, this is Sushant, Kochar. Today we are going to talk about what is the healthy body fat percentage for men and women. So for men, healthy body fat percentage can be around 14 to 17% body fat. For women, it can be around 21 to 24% body fat. You can be a bit on the lesser end as well, so like 1 or 2% lesser is okay. 1 or 2% more than the then let's say 17% is also okay-ish, maybe, but if you tend to go more far from the range, far from this range, then you it can be harmful for you. And if you gain significant more fat than this, then it can be harmful for your health. So staying around this range is fine. So I'm going to be talking from the perspective of men. For women, they can add 7 to 8% body fat to their numbers. So I have explained that in my previous videos. So if for a man, body fat percentage, the respective or corresponding woman's body fat percentage would be 7 to 8 plus than the man's body fat percentage. I have explained that in my previous videos. So you can see, say 14 plus 7 is 21 and 17 plus 7 is 24, so 7 to 8% difference on similar fitness levels. Now there has been a debate. If you ask me, that is there no specific number like 15% body fat for men is going to be good for everyone? So so if there are three people, it is not necessary that all of them, if all of them have 14% body fat, it is equally good for them. So for someone 13% body fat can be good, someone 15% body fat can be good, someone 14% body fat can be good. So it has been controversial. There has been debate on this. Okay, so I was saying you can go 1 to 2% lesser than this range as well, but this is the general range. When you start going lesser towards the lesser body fat percentage than this range of 14 to 17, then that is a range where athletes stay. But lower fat percentages like 10%, 9%, 8% or even lesser are not always maintainable. They are hard to maintain, because to maintain such fat percentages, you have to be really conscious about your diet and exercise. But it is hard to be so conscious or so strict on yourself year round for the whole year. So it is for a general public, it is usually not easy to maintain. And this channel is for general layman, is general public layman. Not everyone competes on a stage. 10 out of 10,000 people might compete on stage. So we are trying to see what the remaining 9,990 people can do in their general lifestyle, and also the rest of the 10 people can also look at the channel in case they want to get some information. Now, so for a general person, a common man, it is hard to maintain maintain the fat percentage like 7, 8 or 19% for the whole year, and there's no need to. So people try to be on low fat percentage to look good, to maintain body fat percentages of where they have their abs visible. But our ancestors have lived for 100 or 100 plus years even when their abs were not visible. So that kind of proves that we do not need abs to live long or live a healthy life. Now, as I said, maintaining abs for the whole year or a low, really low body fat percentage like 6 to 10% is hard to do for a common man, because there would be a lot of time when you encounter a situation where someone else is eating pizza and you are on your diet, and when you keep doing that for the whole year, it kind of starts to become a burden on your brain. It puts a lot of pressure on your head. So basically, it is not always mental labor, and maybe your body does not want to stay on such body fat percentages like 6 to 9 or 10%. Maybe because many a times you would see when someone loses weight and comes down to a body fat percentage of let's say 7%, and that person quits the diet, is eating normal healthy food, no junk food, and exercising regularly, then the body slowly starts to raise the body fat percentage to 10% plus body fat percentages. This might be an indicator that the body does not want to be on so low body fat percentages, because one of the main goals of fat being in the body is that fat is a storage for the hard time. When you do not have enough food to eat, the body can derive storage from the fat for your survival. So body might not like you to be on so low body fat percentage because you're going against that principle of survival. So maybe at the same time, body does not want you to be on 35% body fat or 30% body fat, because there you are putting too much load on your body, carrying all that weight around, and you are calling for a lot of diseases. But there is some fat that the body wants to keep. So maybe that is the reason that body tries to push you above 10% body fat levels when even you're eating healthy and exercising. This happens many times. This case happens many times, that people come down to 7% body fat, quits the diet, start eating normally. They do not gain a lot of fat, and they are still exercising, but their body tries to push the body fat percentage to 10 plus numbers. So basically, for an individual, healthy can be where the body tries to settle on clean eating and exercise. So one might say, okay, my body has settled down on 30% body fat for the last 5 years, so I think that is where my body wants to settle, so that is a naturally healthy place for me to be in. Body does not want to have too much fat. So what I would suggest it is you do the right diet and exercise, and you lose weight and you come down to this sort of body fat range, 14-15%, and then you keep working out, you keep eating clean, and then your body would saturate around the body fat where it is comfortable. So that is what I would ask you to do, so to find out where your body wants to settle. And it is not going to be the case that your body again takes you back to 35%, because the body does not want too much fat. That is the tendency of the body. Unless or until you have any sort of disease or you have metabolic damage or something like that, your body would not do any such thing. Your body would want to be in a place where the fat is neither too low nor too high. So a bit above 10% is maintainable, where you can have your abs blurred, or maybe you do not have the abs visible. But that is fine. You do not need to maintain abs for the whole year to be healthy. So there is no need to run behind abs. But make sure that you have a flat belly in the first place. You want to have a flat belly even if you do not have the abs visible. Now, very low body fat percentage, like 2-5%, are bad for health. I have mentioned that in my previous videos. Now, a bit more fat, so there is a person on 11-12% body fat, and there is a person on 16-17% body fat. So the person on 16-17% body fat has a bit more fat in his body. So that person would feel the body to be a bit heavier, and that person can also get a feeling of being stronger as the body is heavier. So he's carrying more weight around. So that feeling of being heavier and stronger can play a big role for you being psychologically happy. It can make you, it can keep you psychologically happy. So that can also be a role to be in, to a reason to be in this fat percentage range. Now, the skinny guys who have really low muscle mass should not try to go down to low fat percentage like 10%, 8%, 9%. They should first try to gain muscle, and then they should try to, when they have gained significant amount of muscle, then they should try to come down to lower fat percentage like 10, 8 or 9, and for the visibility of abs. Now, so let's say you're a guy who has low muscle mass and high fat mass and you are at 30%, so you should come down to a fat percentage of 14-15% and then try to gain muscle. And then when you gain muscle, you'll gain some fat. So try to again, so your fat percentage goes up, then again try to come back to 14-15% by cutting fat and retaining muscle. Then again repeat the procedure till you feel that you have significant amount of muscle, and then you can try going down to 10%, 9%, 8%, 45%. Otherwise, low muscle mass guys, if they try to go to low fat percentages, they can harm their health. Now, so basically now you can stop getting so much influenced by the pictures, flourished on the internet, where you see a bodybuilder in his best condition of abs and muscles showing their look. You see the shape of the muscle and you think, oh, I want to be like this guy. So basically that is not really maintainable, that is not easily maintainable for the whole life. So rather run for something which is maintainable, which is healthy, which keeps your mind happy, and do not necessarily run for abs. So if you try to maintain a state where you have to be on a diet every day, it can keep a burden on your brain. It can make a pressure on your brain when you see others eating what they want to, and you have to forcefully eat this particular food because you want to be staying on this particular body fat percentage. Even the bodybuilders do not maintain that visible abs state for the whole year. The pictures that you see on internet are mostly their competition time pictures. So they click a lot of pictures when they are competing, when they are in good shape, and they'll keep posting those pictures for the whole year. And you would think, oh, that guy is looking like this for the whole year. That is not the case majority of the time. They have a off competition stage where their abs are either blurred or might be completely hidden. So basically that is what I wanted to tell you. In case you like the video, please like, comment and share. I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.